What is Zookeeper and how exactly Zookeeper helps you in distributed systems? If you would have read a bit about Kafka, HBase, Hadoop, Hive, Flink, Neo4j and lots of such technologies, you would have seen that they use Zookeeper under the hood. And many times when you read about their tutorial or when you read their documentation, they mention that Zookeeper helps in the coordination between the multiple services. So if there are multiple servers running within the cluster, the Zookeeper helps in coordinating. But very few places they explain how. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how Zookeeper actually helps you in coordinating in the distributed system. So Zookeeper is being used not just by these technologies, but also by big companies like Netflix, Twitter, Facebook, Yahoo in one way or the other. So the intent of this video is that once you encounter any scenario in your own project, you should be able to judge if Zookeeper is the right solution for you or not. And you should be able to use Zookeeper independently. So let's quickly get started. Now, if you see about distributed system, what exactly is distributed system? We can define it as a system in which there is no one single master or single king or queen. If one dies, the other machines would come and take the charge. So that's the overall definition or the way you can think about the distributed system. Now the problem is that if you have multiple services running for you in your own company or in your own project, you would want them to coordinate with each other. You would not want them to fight among each other for any of the resources or any of configuration sharing or leader election. There are lots of things which you would want to do. Or for example, you would want to divide the workload that, hey, server number 1, can you process me the request between 1 to 1000? Server number 2, can you do that for 1001 to 2000, etc. So you would want these services to coordinate and not fight among themselves. So then it becomes a bit challenging. For example, if you want to communicate, the network latency is not zero. It is something. So you cannot just keep on bombarding all the data coming to all the servers to each other. And last but not the least, there would be multiple admins, because these servers would be located in various different geographical locations. For example, this is located in US, this is located in India, this is located in Australia. So all these data centers would have different admins, and yet you would want to coordinate these servers among each other. So there are a lot of things which you need to take care of when you design a distributed system. Now let's look into a problem statement. That is a problem statement in which we'll see how your life would look like if you do not have Zookeeper. And then we will move on to a solution where we have a Zookeeper. So this is overall system that you have a configuration management system. That is, you want some configuration, and by configuration I mean set of key value pairs. Key can be something like use apple equal to true and use oranges equal to false. And in your code you would have some logic that if apple equal to true, do something, and if orange equal to true, do something else. So these configurations you keep somewhere. So there are multiple ways to keep it. You can keep them in the server itself in a configuration files. But the problem is that for that you would need to update all the files in one go, which again becomes a challenge. The requirement is that the moment you change the configuration, those configurations should be reflected on all the servers. So you cannot keep the individual files on all the servers. What else you could do? You could have one database or one service, and all the other services will keep on polling for the new configuration. And this is how they can get the job done. They can keep on polling every X seconds to get the data. And the moment the data changes, they would come to know and they will act based on it. However, there is an extra headache of polling because now you need to constantly keep on polling that, hey, what's my configuration? What's my configuration, etc. So that's a problem. And let's see if we can solve it more efficiently with Zookeeper. What is Zookeeper? Zookeeper is an open source project by Apache. And it is written in Java. It's a backend service and provides a way for the client to implement tasks for the distributed system. So overall, Zookeeper is a service. And the clients, the other clients would connect to that service to get their tasks done. And it is designed in a way that you can model your problem statements to Zookeeper. How exactly? We'll see that in the coming slides. Zookeeper was originally developed by Yahoo. So let's quickly see the solution with Zookeeper. You can define the Zookeeper into two sections, that is the client and the server. The server is actually the cluster of multiple servers. So these are nothing but machines, machine 1, machine 2 and machine 3. And these all together is called as Zookeeper ensemble. This is the terminology they give. And these are the Zookeeper clients. Client 1, client 2, client 3. And all of these machines would be located anywhere in the world. And they can be cross data centers, etc. as well. There are few things which makes the life easy with Zookeeper. The first is that Zookeeper server maintains the first in, first out model. That is, if there are n number of clients, they are making n number of requests. Zookeeper will make sure that the request is processed in first in, first out order. The second is it stores the data. You can keep some configurations in the server, just like the database. And also, this is the most interesting part, that it informs the client for any change in the data. So you earlier used to have database. In fact, you have the database even now, and you can keep the data in the database. But the problem is your database will not inform you for any changes. You can have database triggers, but eventually it's a poll mechanism. Here, the moment anything changes in the data and the client subscribe to those changes, the Zookeeper will inform the clients that this particular data has changed, and then they can get the data. So you avoid the polling overall. And with the help of these three properties, the clients can build their own system. So you can literally have just one Zookeeper server running in your company, and you can have multiple solutions with the same Zookeeper. For example, in your client 1, you can implement leader election. Client 2, you can implement queue. And likewise in other cases. So, for example, in client 1, what you can do is, since it maintains first in, first out, all the clients will request that, hey, I want to be a leader. And the first one will get the access to be a leader. And the moment that client goes offline, the Zookeeper server will inform all the clients that, hey, this client is offline. Let's now collect a new leader. So now this logic of let's now collect a new leader will be at the client side. Zookeeper will just inform that, hey, this client died. Likewise, you can store the configurations. Again, you will store the configuration here, and all the clients, when they come live, they will get the configuration from the Zookeeper server. And the moment the configuration changes, the Zookeeper server will inform that, hey, this particular data has changed, and all the clients will poll the server to get the new data. So in this way, this problem can also be solved. Likewise, taking the lock, all these problem statements will talk in detail. But if you see all these problem statements, these can be modeled in terms of first in, first out, storing the data and having a callback. So earlier we talked about the configuration management system. So there as well, you store a data in all the servers, and all you need to do is to subscribe to any change to that data, and Zookeeper will do it for you. There is a persistent connection established between client and the server. That is a TCP based connection. And that's how the whole logic of callback works. I hope this video would have clarified that why exactly Zookeeper is needed and what is a problem statement which database could not solve and which Zookeeper could exactly solve. That is, you can subscribe for any changes, not just store the data, but also subscribe for the changes for those data. And while storing the data or sending the events, you can maintain the first in, first out order. Now, people who would have used things like Apache Kafka, they would say that this is a similar problem which is solved in Apache Kafka. That is, you know, first in, first out, and you can subscribe to any queue, etc. But guess what? Apache Kafka also uses Zookeeper under the hood. Of course, in the latest version, they are trying to get away with that. But for the most of the time, they have been using Zookeeper. So if you see that there are a lot of problem statements, not just these, which will be solved with Zookeeper. There are many others. So we'll see and implement each of those solutions in the coming videos. Till the next time, bye.